Hi my honeys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I just wanted to sit here and just play with some eyeshadow. I haven't played with pink glitter in a very, very long time. And I used to play with glitter so much back in the day. If you go back and watch my old videos, I would always play with glitter. And I'm just a sucker for eyeshadows, you guys. I truly, truly am so in love. And when I get to just sit here, watch some Netflix and do and create these eyeshadow looks, you guys, it just really like warms up my heart, to be honest. It's so much fun, and I have like, I can see all of my palettes here on my desk, and it's just a fun time, and it's like my therapy. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Comment down below, let me know what other creative eyeshadow looks you want to see here on my channel. So with that said, let's go ahead and get started, and I'm going to show you guys how I created this smoky pink eye cut crease.
So of course, first things first, whenever I'm gonna go into some really intense eyeshadows and I really want them to pop, I go into my Urban Decay Eden Primer. I'm taking this Jaw Cosmetics CC number 3 cut crease brush. Absolutely the best brush, you guys, that I've ever used to create my cut creases or to clean up under my brow like I'm doing right now, and applying my eye primer all over the lid. Now you can definitely use concealer, whatever works for you and whatever makes it easier for you, but I feel like the Urban Decay Eden Primer can be a little bit drying, so just an FYI, but it really, I don't know, I feel like it really helps my eyeshadows pop a lot more, makes them last a lot longer as well. It kind of has like this matte dry finish, so that whenever I apply my eyeshadows on top, like they start off a little dry, like the eyeshadows, but then once you start building that intensity, oh my gosh, you guys, it's like seriously magic in a bottle. I absolutely love this Urban Decay Eden Primer. Next, I'm gonna go into my e.l.f. Eye Tapes. So this is just gonna give us a nice clean application towards that outer corner of the eye, and it's really gonna make it look snatched and like pulled back. You can find these e.l.f. Eye Tapes, you guys, either at Walmart or Target. You can even find them online. So for the palette today, I'm gonna be going into the Morphe 3503 Fierce by Nature palette. I'm sorry if they don't have it available. If they do, I will link it down below for you guys. So I'm gonna be picking up this nice burgundy shade. And for the brush today, I'm gonna go into the Morphe M506 brush. This is really just gonna help us place the eyeshadow where we want it and pretty much in the crease. And then we're gonna work it all the way going towards the outer corner of the eye, close to those eye tapes. And this is really gonna help it look kind of like a cut crease, but we just really wanna pull the eyeshadow going back. Next, you guys, I'm gonna go into this nice light, like coral color, and I'm gonna go into my Morphe M433 brush, and pretty much what we're gonna do is just blend out the edges, make it look nice and soft. So now that we went in with the smaller Morphe M506 to kind of place the eyeshadow where we want it to go, we're going in with the Morphe M433 with that next eyeshadow just to smooth everything out and make it look nice and blended. So now I'm going to go back into that Morphe M433, pretty much going back to that same shade that we placed the first time with the M506, and now going and switching it over to the Morphe M433, picking up some more product and just kind of touching it up a little bit more and intensifying it. Now we're going to intensify it just a little bit more. I'm going to go into that nice dark brown shade using the Morphe M506. I'm going to take it towards the outer corner in the crease. And then with whatever I have left, I try best to not bring it all the way towards the inner corner. I mainly just want to focus the darkness towards the outer corner of the eye. Once I've placed that, I do go back into that burgundy shade and I do buff out the edges so that way we don't lose that burgundy shade as well. But at the same time, we're blending out and blending both of those shades together. I hope this all is making sense. All right, guys, so now I'm gonna go back into that Jaw CC number 3 concealer or cut crease brush, whatever you wanna call it, and then taking the Urban Decay Eden Primer, I'm gonna start to just carve out my crease. As you guys are seeing here, I am going a little bit higher than my natural crease. This will really help to make my lid look and appear a little bit larger and make it seem like I have a lot of lid space. So that's a good tip for any of my hooded eyes girls. If you want your lid to look a little bit, you know, bigger, take up that crease a little bit higher with that product, and I promise you it will look like you have a lot of lid space. And so pretty much, you guys, eyes, I'm going to stop it towards that outer corner right there. I don't want to cover it all up because we are doing a half cut crease look. You can also use concealer if you don't have the Urban Decay Edam Primer. To blend out, you guys, that harsh line that you see here from the primer, I'm using a flat Morphe brush. I don't remember the number. Unfortunately, it did came in a brush set, but whatever brush you want to use to just blend that harsh line out. So that way, once we go in with the brown again, you can't see that peeking through. So make sure that harsh line of demarcation is blended out. Next up, you guys, I'm going into the Huda Beauty. This is their Matte and Metal Melted Shadows. It is a double-ended product. So I'm gonna go into the shade called Wednesday, and this is the matte melted shadow side. And I'm gonna go into the Morphe M167, and what we're gonna do is apply this pretty much all over the lid. We're gonna take it all the way towards that outer corner, and then we will blend out that outer corner with the dark brown. But first, let's apply this shade, and then we are gonna go into the glitter. Now I'm gonna go into that dark brown shade, you guys, with the Morphe M433, and pat, pat, pat your life away until that line is not there anymore. And now I'm gonna go into the shade called Froyo. It's that melted metal shadow. It's more glittery than the first shade that we used from that Huda Beauty Matte and Metal Melted Shadow. So I'm still using that same Morphe M167, and then I don't know why I didn't show you guys, but the glitter is from MAC Cosmetics. I will link it down below for you guys. I don't have it right now here around my desk area where I edit my videos, but I will not miss it. I promise I will add it down below for you. I didn't apply any glitter adhesive. Unfortunately, I am completely out. I need to go buy a new one. I didn't notice that I was out. So for me, using this nice matte and melted shadow, that Froyo, is like a base for the glitter. And let me tell you, it worked wonders. I'm gonna go into my Balm Cosmetics. This is their Schwing Liquid Matte Liner. So good, you guys. If you've been an OG to my channel, you know that I've used this eyeliner many, many times. It is seriously so good. As soon as you apply it to the skin, it dries completely matte and it does not go anywhere. Definitely check it out. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply the liner in a slant way, as you guys are seeing here, pretty much creating a half wing. We're not gonna do a complete wing, but if that's what you wanna do, go ahead and, you know, be my guest. But I'm gonna just do it halfway. And then I'm gonna go into the Morphe M506 and picking up some of that matte shadow from that Morphe palette and just pretty much patting some eyeshadow towards that outer corner to really smooth out and diffuse, I think that's how you say it, diffuse that harsh black line from the liner. And once we've done that, you guys, I'm gonna remove the eye tapes and just watch. Look how clean that looks. Such a clean application. And if you are messy like me, these will definitely do you justice. For my lower lash line, you guys, I don't have a specific eyeliner that is magenta, so I'm just gonna go in with a lip pencil. This one I believe is from Morphe. I will, I think you kind of see the name there, but I will link it down below for you guys. Pretty much, we're gonna use this as our base, and then we're gonna jump in to this Bibella brush. I love her, or actually from Beauty Creations, not Bibella, sorry. And pretty much the eyeshadow that we use in the crease, we're gonna bring it down below. For my waterline, I'm gonna go into the Tres Luce Beauty Liner. So they have different colors, you guys, and I love their nude shade. I will link it down below for you guys if you are interested, but it's so good, it's so creamy, and it does last a very long time. I'm gonna go into Benefit's Their Real Magnet Mascara to coat my bottom lashes. And that's pretty much it, you guys, for today's pink cut crease glitter eyeshadow moment. I hope you guys learned something today. That is definitely the goal for me with my makeup videos. It's just to, you know, yeah, to have a good time, but also I want you guys to learn something and get better at doing your own makeup. I love you guys so, so much.